back, dear students. Today I will tell you a very interesting short story, a very famous bedtime story written by O. Henry. And O. Henry, it is actually the pen name of William Sidney Porter, who was an American short story writer. And I hope you have already learned some short stories written by him, and the famous works are The Gift of the Maggie, After 20 Years, The Cop and the Anthem. So, you have to keep in mind, O. Henry is the pen name of William Sidney Porter. Fine? Last Leaf. This is a very famous short story written by O. Henry. His actual name is William Sidney Porter, and he published this in his collection called The Trimmed Lamb and Other Story in the year 1907. And this story is set in Greenwich Village during a pneumonia epidemic, and it tells the story of an old artist who saves the life of a young neighboring artist dying of pneumonia by giving her the will to live. So this incident has been set up in a village called Greenwich Village, and it is in New York. Fine. So now let's start the lesson in detail. It is autumn, the wind is blowing hard and it's raining heavily. All the leaves on an ivy creeper has fallen except one. Why doesn't the last leaf fall? So this is a scenario. It is an autumn season and the wind is very hard and it is raining very heavily. And during the autumn season we can see the leaves will be falling down, and the same thing happened with an ivy creeper. Sue and John C., two young artists, shared a small flat. The flat was on the third story of an old house. John C. felt very seriously ill in November. She had pneumonia. She would lie in her bed without moving, just gazing out of the window. Sue, her friend, became very worried. She sent for the doctor. Although he came every day, there was no change in John's condition. So you should know about the backdrop of the story. This story is set up in Greenwich Village, and that is an area where the old poor artists are living. Okay, this is not a high-fi area, it is not a posh area. All the poor artists used to live over there. And there live two young artists named Sue and John C., and they are sharing a small flat. And what happened with John C.? During November, she is being affected by pneumonia, and she is just laying on the bed without moving, and her friend Sue is very afraid about her, and she sent for the doctor, and although he came every day, there was no change in John C.'s condition. One day, the doctor asked Sue aside and asked her, "Is anything worrying John C.?" "No," replied Sue. "But why do you ask?" The doctor said, "John C., it seems, has made up her mind that she is not getting to get well. If she doesn't want to live, medicines will not help her." So here is the actual reason. Even though she is suffering from pneumonia, she is getting proper medications, but she is not showing any improvement in her physique. The reason is that she is totally pessimistic. She is not having the longing to live in her life. And the doctor is also asking to her friend whether she is suffering from any troubles. And she is not willingly taking all these medications. That is why she is not showing any improvement in her body. Sue tried her best to make John C. take an interest in things around her. She talked about clothes and fashions, but John C. did not respond. John C. continued to lie still on her bed. Sue brought her drawing board into John C.'s room and started painting. To take John C.'s mind off her illness, she whistled while working. So here we can see how a good friend is helping her intimate friend. Sue is trying her level best to retrieve John C. from her illness. And in order to motivate her, in order to give her a hope in life, she is even doing all the works in her room, so that when John C. is seeing that Sue is working, she will also get a tendency, she will be motivated to see this. And in order to make her entertain, even Sue used to whistle while she is drawing. Suddenly, Sue heard Jonesy whisper something. She quickly rushed to the bed and heard Jonesy counting backwards. She was looking out of the window and was saying 12. After some time, she whispered 11, then 10, then 9, 8, 7. Sue anxiously looked out of the window. She saw an old ivy creeper climbing halfway up the brick wall opposite their window. In the strong wind outside, the creeper was shedding its leaves. So here we can see what is actually running in the mind of Jonesy. Okay, so now Sue is just working in Jonesy's room, and one day she had heard something quite unfamiliar. And what was that? Jonesy is counting backwards. Okay, and first she was counting 12, after a while she is counting 11, 10, 9, 8 and 7. And when Sue looked out anxiously through the window, she had seen Jonesy is looking in an old ivy creeper. Ivy creeper means it is somewhat like a grapevine. Okay, it is a creeper plant and it looks similar to a grapevine, and it was just climbing halfway up the brick wall opposite their window. And in the strong wind and during this autumn season, what is happening? The creeper is just shedding its leaves. It is autumn season and it is heavily raining. So we can obviously think that the trees and the plants will shed their leaves. The same is happening with this ivy plant. Sue asked. 6, whispered Jonesy. They are falling faster now. 3 days ago, there were almost 100 leaves. There are only 5 left now. It is autumn, said Sue, and the leaves will fall. When the last leaf falls, I will die, said Jonesy with finality. I have known this for the last 3 days. Oh, that is nonsense, replied Sue. What have old ivy leaves to do with your getting well? The doctor is confident that you will get better. Jonesy did not say anything. Sue went and brought her a bowl of soup. I don't want any soup, said Jonesy. I'm not hungry. Now there are only 4 leaves left. I want to see the last one fall before it gets dark. Then I will sleep forever. Sue sat on Jonesy's bed, kissed her and said, you are not going to die. I can't draw the curtain for I need the light. I wanted to finish the painting and get some money for us. So now Jonesy is counting the leaves of the ivy plant, and she is just whispering the number of leaves are getting reduced day by day. And for her, she is just equating her life with the ivy plant. She is equating her number of days in this world, in this earth, by the number of leaves in the ivy plant. She is telling that for 3 days I am just counting this leaves, and in the first day it was like 100 leaves, and now there are only a few, and now just 5 are left, and it is falling very faster. And just Sue is trying to make her understand that it is autumn season and it will obviously fall, but Jones is not ready to listen to her, and she's saying that I don't care, I can relate this ivy plant with my life. And the doctor is very confident that you will get back. Sue is just trying to make her understand the situation, but Jonesy is unwilling to listen to anything, and she is even denying her the soup Sue has bought for her, and she is just worried about the number of leaves that is left in this plant. And Jonesy is always looking through the window, and Sue cannot close the curtain. She cannot draw the curtain of the window because she is getting the light through that window. And only if she is making a good picture, she can sell it and she can find out the money for their survival. Please, my dear friend, she begged Jonesy, promise not to look out of the window while I paint. So Jonesy is unable to do anything. And Sue is unable to make her understand anything. So Jonesy is always looking through the window and she is just climbing the number of leaves. And Sue is just requesting her not to look through that window. When I am painting, you just look on the painting, not look on this. Don't look on this window, on this creeper. All right, said Jhansi, finish your painting soon, for I want to see the last leaf fall. I am tired of waiting, I have to die, so let me go away peacefully like one of those poor, tired leaves. See the mental situation of Jhansi. She is just thinking that when the last leaf will fall down, she will also move from this world. She will also go to this eternal world. And you just better finish your work very soon so that I can peacefully look at these leaves and I will have a peaceful voyage. Try to sleep, said Sue. I have to paint an old miner. I will call Burnham up to be my model. So what is a work to be done by Sue? She is going to paint an old miner, and for that she need a model. She needs a model, and she is going to call Mr. Burman. Burman is a old artist seen in Greenwich Village. She rushed down. Burman lived on the ground floor. He was a 60-year-old painter. His lifelong dream was to paint a masterpiece, but that had remained a dream. Sue poured out her worries to Burman. She told him how Jhansi was convinced that she would die when the last leaf fell. So now we can see the description about the old painter, Mr. Burman. He is a 60-year-old painter, and his lifelong dream was to paint a masterpiece. But till now, he is unable to do so. Okay, and now Sue just told all her worries to Mr. Burman, and she is just asking him the advice how to make Jhansi understand that she is not gonna to die. Is she stupid? Asked Burman. How can she be so foolish? She is running a high temperature, complained Sue. She refuses to eat or drink, and that worries me a lot. So hearing the nature of Jhansi, Burman was getting agitated towards Jhansi and asking, is she this foolish? And for Sue, the problem is that she is having high temperature. Jhansi is having high temperature and she is refusing what all things she is providing her to eat and drink. I will come with you and see Jhansi, Burman said. They tiptoed into the room. Jhansi was sleeping. Sue drew the curtains together and they went to the next room. She peeped out through the window. There was only one leaf on the creeper. It was raining heavily and an icy cold wind was blowing. It seemed as though the leaf would fall any minute now. Burman did not say a word. He went back to his room. So right now, Burman and Sue, they just reached the room of Jhansi, and by the time Jhansi was sleeping and they just tiptoed into her room, means they just entered the room without making any noise. And they just peeped through the window and there was only one leaf left on that ivy creeper. And it was raining very heavily and it is an icy cold wind blowing over there. And it is very evident that within a minute, this leaf will be falling down. And seeing all these things, Burman did not say even a word and he just went back to his room. Jhansi woke up next morning. In a feeble voice, she asked Sue to draw the curtains. Sue was nervous. She drew back the curtains very reluctantly. So this night, Jhansi was sleeping. So when she woke up, she immediately wanted to see the ivy plant, and she is asking Jhansi to just move the curtains in a very feeble voice. Feeble voice means in a very fragile voice, very weak voice. And Sue was very nervous because if the leaves are not there, if the leaf is not there, obviously Jhansi will be totally demotivated and no one can help her come out of it. So she was reluctantly moving the curtains. She was unwillingly moving the curtains. Oh, Sue exclaimed as she looked at the vine creeper. Look, there is still one leaf on the creeper. So see the happiness. We can see when she drew the curtains, we can see a leaf on the creeper. There is a single leaf on the vine creeper. And it looks quite green and healthy in spite of the storm and the fierce wind it didn't fall. So how healthy is this green leaves? It is quite healthy and green, and in this fierce and thundering storms, it doesn't fall. It means it is such a strong leaf. "Heard the wind last night," said Jhonsi. "I thought it would have fallen. It will surely fall today, then I'll die." "You won't die," said Sue energetically. "You have to leave for your friends. What would happen to me if you die?" Jhonsi smiled weakly and closed her eyes. After every hour or so, she would look out of the window and find the leaf still there. It seemed to be clinging to the creeper. "Susie," Jhonsi told Sue that last night I have heard the fearful thundering storms and I was very sure that the leaf will fall today and I will also die. But Jhonsi is making her understand that if you are dying, what will happen to me? No one else is there for me in this world. And Jhonsi just smiled weakly and just closed her eyes, and every hour she used to just peep through the curtains and see and make sure that the creeper is still alive. The leaf is still on the creeper. In the evening, there was another storm, but the leaf did not fall. Jhonsi lay for a long time looking at the leaf. Then she called out to Sue, "I have been a bad girl. You have looked after me so lovingly and I have not cooperated with you. I have been depressed and gloomy. The last leaf has shown me how wicked I have been. I have realized that it is a sin to want to die." So after a while, after some time, by evening, again there was a heavy storm. But even after that, the leaf is still surviving. And Jhonsi just lay for a long time looking at the leaf, and then she called Sue and she just said her that she was always a loving friend. Sue is always a loving friend, and Jhonsi has treated her in a very bad way. Because she was in a depressed mood and she was so gloomy, she doesn't cooperate with Sue. And this leaf has shown me the real life. And I realize that it is a great sin to wish to die. Sue hugged Jhonsi. Then she gave her lots of hot soup and a mirror. Jhonsi combed her hair and smiled brightly. So after hearing the words of Jhonsi, Sue just hugged Jhonsi and she gave her some hot soup, because for 2-3 days she hasn't eaten anything. So immediately she had given her some hot soup and a mirror. And seeing the mirror, Jhonsi combed her hair and she smiled very happily. In the afternoon, the doctor came. After examining his patient, he told Sue, "Jhonsi now has a will to live. I am confident she will recover soon. Now I must go downstairs and see Berman. He is also suffering from pneumonia, but I am afraid there is no hope for him." So right now the doctor also arrived. By afternoon, the doctor arrived. And after examining Jhonsi, he made the statement that now Jhonsi has improved. She is having the willingness to leave. And I am very confident that she will recover from this pneumonia. But I am worried about Mr. Berman, who is also suffering from pneumonia, and there is no hope for him. The next morning, Sue came and sat on Jhonsi's bed taking Jhonsi's hand in hers. And she said, "I have something to tell you. Mr. Berman died of pneumonia this morning. He was ill for only 2 days. The first day, the janitor found him on his bed. His clothes and shoes were wet and he was shivering. He had been out in that stormy night." So next morning, what happened? Sue just came and sat nearby Jhonsi and told her that, "I have something bad to tell you, that Mr. Berman died of pneumonia this morning. Mr. Berman is not anymore, and he was just suffering from pneumonia just for 2 days. And the first day he was just found on the bed wearing his clothes and shoes that were wet, and he was even shivering. And he was standing the whole night during this stormy night. He was just staying outside during this stormy night, and he has been totally wet and shivering." They found a ladder and a lantern still light and lying near his bed. There were also some brushes and green and yellow paints on the floor near the ladder. "Jhonsi, dear," said Sue, "look out of the window. Look at that ivy leaf. Haven't you wondered why it doesn't flutter when the wind blows? That is Berman's masterpiece. He painted it the night the last leaf fell. So this is the climax of the story. There we can see when Mr. Burman was found laying nearby him, there was a ladder and a lantern, and there was some brushes and green and yellow colors, yellow paints on the floor nearby the ladder. And do you know something? When the wind is blowing over there, why this ivy leaves are not fluttering? Because it is not a real leaf. It is the masterpiece of Mr. Burman. When the last leaf of the ivy plant has fallen down, what he has done? He just made a replica. He just painted an exact ivy leaf. And that seems like a real leaf to you. And that is why you are still alive. So I hope you enjoyed this lesson and read the lesson thoroughly. And if you have any doubt, please clarify the earliest. And I hope this story will remain in your mind forever. I am really delighted to teach you this story and read the textbook thoroughly. Thank you.